The glaciers have taken a beating the last couple of years. For them to continue to take this beating year in and out with these really harsh summers, occurrence of marine heat waves, advection of those warm temperatures onto land and up into the mountains, they're cooking.
This big overall goal of measuring how glaciers change involves work from people from across different institutions in New Zealand. We need to act quickly to mitigate the worst effects of climate change, but we still can do that.
Our photograph observations for the end of summer snowline survey start in the late 1970s. It represents a very long and nearly unbroken record of photographic evidence of glacier change in the Southern Alps. And what we can see is that some of the glaciers that are at lower elevation in those perimeter areas around the central Southern Alps, they are approaching an extinction horizon. We are seeing how much volume we started with in 1977, and with our reconstruction of ice volume change using the snowline record, we're able to see that they're on a path towards extinction.
On the snowline survey, we take hundreds of photos of glaciers and we put them into the software, and it can give us these three-dimensional models. When we were doing the flight, we flew around and we took all these photos of Brewster Glacier. So there's photos of each part of the glacier from lots of different angles. And when we look at a model from 2016 to 2023, it's very clear where glaciers have kind of lost big parts of the ice.
We flew over this glacier a few days ago, and from the air it was really striking how much the ice has retreated, both at the terminus where I'm sitting at the moment, but also on the margins. A glacier shouldn't be losing ice at the top. You would expect it always to be from the bottom upwards, but when things are really going badly for a glacier, then it will lose ice at the top as well, and that's what's happening here.
Mindful when you walk away, if it is sloping ground, the blade.
The snow stake program was started as a collaboration between University of Otago and Victoria University of Wellington back in the early 2000s.
We are at Brewster Glacier, which is a benchmark glacier for measuring the mass balance of a glacier, and the mass balance being whether it's growing or shrinking. We do snow probing using a snow probe just to measure the height of the snow, how much snow came in. And then at the same time, we install these ablation stakes using steam drills, placing these thin PVC stakes, which are 10 meters in length, and they become our measuring sticks. And it allows us to come back at the end of summer and really observe how much snow and then ice melted.
We installed these snow stakes back in November 2022, so they've had 5 months in the glacier, and what we've found quite clearly is that there's been a lot of snow and ice loss. At this particular point, we measured 2.3 metres of snow depth back in November. So what's actually happened is that we've lost not only the 2.3 metres of snow, but we've also lost around 3.7 metres of ice.
Now what we're seeing is that snow tends to melt pretty quickly. We lose what we get, and then it gets into the ice and melts that ice, and so you lose the reservoir that you've got as well. And that's what's happening broadly in the Southern Alps and across all glaciers globally.
By putting all three of these elements together, the end of summer snowline photos, the snow stake survey, and the structure for motion photogrammetry, we're able to transform our much longer data into an ice volume chain to indicate what amount of water has been lost since the late 1970s.
The reality is that we're living the script and we're writing the script at the same time, and we are in charge of the outcomes for future generations. And so, to me, if we think that's valuable and we want them to have those experiences like we've enjoyed, then We have an issue to deal with. Got to get on top of it right now.